Hey, what's going on, everyone? This is Aaron Bennett here. I want to jump into the crypto and Bitcoin news for today. So let's go ahead and get started with the stories I want to talk about. So the first from Cointelegraph, it reads, wallets holding 0.1 or more Bitcoin hit all-time high as the halving looms. So the record number of Bitcoin hodlers are hedging their savings against central banks. And the other story I want to talk about today, kind of a cool story, you can now buy .crypto domains from my Ether wallet. So you can create a, you know, Aaron.crypto or your name.crypto and have that hosted on the Ethereum, or domains hosted on Ethereum that act as a portal to the censorship resistant decentralized web. So really, really cool story. I want to jump into that. But first, let's go back to this first story from Cointelegraph. So there are more people right now who have 0.1 or more Bitcoin in wallets than ever. So the number of addresses holding at least 0.1 BTC has exceeded the 3 million mark for the first time as hodlers brace for the halving. So for the first time ever, we've hit the 3 million mark for people for the number of addresses. So this doesn't mean 3 million people. This is obviously going to be less than 3 million people since you can have multiple Bitcoin addresses, but pretty cool that we reached this 3 million mark, especially going up to this very pivotal time, obviously with what's going on with the economy, but also with the halving coming up. So analysts who adhere to the efficient markets hypothesis believe that the halving is already priced in and will not significantly affect the price. However, there are those who believe that the markets are irrational and that the market dynamics is better described by behavioral economics instead. So, at least for the moment, the latter may have an upper hand. All right, so hedge against fiat. Interestingly, even the halving of the price on Black Thursday has not slowed the growth of addresses holding at least 0.1 Bitcoin. While those holding 0.1 Bitcoin cannot be identified as whales, that means people who have a ton of Bitcoin, so that's usually like 100, 200, 300 Bitcoin or more, thousands of Bitcoin. This growth likely reflects the greater adoption and accumulation by retail investors. So that's huge. So retail investors getting involved, adopting it, accumulating Bitcoin. It also comes at a time when central banks around the world are flooding the economy with money. It's absolutely crazy how much money is flooding, trillions and trillions. I know you guys have been following the news regarding this. So this may be an attempt on the part of the public to hedge their savings against the debasement of fiat currencies. So I know a lot of people who are invested in Bitcoin, crypto, gold, silver, other things as well. I mean, if you want to go into bullets or whatever type of prepping you want to do, they're hedging their savings against the possible inflation of the US dollar. So some find it undeniable that recent socioeconomic events will have a favorable effect on Bitcoin. Only time will tell. All right, so that's a really good story. I mean, for me personally, I like that story. It says that there's just more people who are holding 0.1 Bitcoin or more. I mean, 0.1 is just an arbitrary number, but you can track that over the last, 10 years since Bitcoin's been around, 10, 12 years. So cool, we hit that big 3 million mark. Next story I want to go over, pretty cool. So let me jump into this. So in brief, Ethereum wallet, my Ether wallet, is now a reseller of .crypto domains. .crypto domains provides users with access to the decentralized web. They can't be shut down by centralized parties like governments or domain name services. So I'm gonna go ahead and jump and get some domains myself after reading the story. I suggest you do too. That's very, very cool. I want to read this entire story to you. Ethereum's My Ether wallet yesterday announced that its users can now buy crypto or .crypto domains. It is the first reseller to do so, making it a domain name registrar. The .crypto domains in question are minted by Unstoppable Domains, a San Francisco-based company that's aiming to create a decentralized web. These domain names are hosted on Ethereum. meaning that no domain service like GoDaddy can shut them down. So what is the difference between .com and .crypto? Regular .com domains are sanctioned by the UN body, ICANN, which it then provides to private registries like VeriSign, who in turn sell them to resellers like GoDaddy. But, explains Brad Kam, co-founder of Unstoppable Domains, any of these centralized institutions can take your .com domain away from you. But if you have a blockchain domain, quote, you store it yourself inside of your wallet. Whoever controls the private key is the only person that can move it around. This is the foundation for user control and censorship resistance. Ethereum web addresses are really just strings of text registered on the blockchain. Unstoppable Domains turns them into readable addresses and sells them for a profit. Now it's selling them to my Ether wallet. Very cool. I like that story a lot. Let's go ahead and check out what's going on with Bitcoin. Bitcoin has been pumping hard. Let's go over to the last 5 days here. 5 days it was at $7,200, dropped down to $68. Now we're at like $7,600 earlier today. This is on the Gemini exchange here. Different exchanges have it a little bit higher. Jumped up to $7,600. Now it's hovering around $7,547. So it's doing really, really well. It's definitely, I thought it would be a little bit lower right now, personally. Definitely it's not immune from having another crash. I mean, Bitcoin is incredibly volatile. You can see here, Bitcoin surges to $7,800. And what I think is that, you know, people who are invested in Bitcoin, for the most part, are doing it to hedge against the dollar, or at least they're very, very aware of that. So everything that's going on with the US economy right now, pumping trillions of dollars, I think there's a lot of people who are jumping into Bitcoin. The $1,200 stimulus checks that came out, I'm sure some of that money went into crypto as well, for sure went into crypto. So I mean, scrolling back 5 days, you can see it's been much, much lower. Going back 1 month, we definitely had that dip down to six. Going back 3 months, we had that massive dip that everybody wishes they bought at around $4,000, $3,900, if y'all remember that. So isn't that funny that this was happened not too long ago? It's happened like a month and a half ago, but people are like, oh man, like that feels like so long ago. I know for me, it feels like forever ago. So, you know, just 3 months ago, we were at, you know, $10,000, $11,000. So there's still a tremendous amount of upswing that'll happen in the crypto markets for sure. Let's go ahead and check out CoinMarketCap and look at the 24-hour winners or gainers for crypto. Hyperion up 15.7, Cosmos up 12.5, Kyber Network up 8, ELF up 7. And looking at the losers, Madesafe Coin down 5.5, Numeraire down 5.23, Quant down 4.7, Status down 4.3. Alrighty guys, that is the video today. Thank you so much for watching. And as always, not as always, well, go ahead and get the 2 free stocks with Webull, links below. You transfer $100 and you get 2 free stocks up to $1,400. Most people are around $20 to $30. If you're not already a member of crypto.com, in my opinion, the best crypto debit card, at least from what I've seen in terms of the features, how much cash back you get, the free Spotify, possibly free Netflix, free Amazon Prime, depending on what level and tier of card you get. Link below to get that as well. You'll get $50 in MCO token when you stake 50 MCO. And we can see MCO here has been doing incredibly well as well. Just looking over the last 3 months, MCO had a low of when the market kind of tanked, a low of like $2.5. Now it's up to $5. We all wish we would have thrown all of our money in here, but hey, we didn't know. So links below for Webull, links below for crypto.com. And until next time, talk with you soon. Peace. Bye-bye.